application of work-energy theorem in the fluid dynamics. Okay? Please write down Bernoulli's theorem. Is the spelling correct? Hey, it's correct.
Bernoulli.
I. This is I only. Oh, there will be comma as well. So please write down in the brackets that Bernoulli's theorem is nothing but application of work energy theorem in the flowing water or flowing fluid. Okay. Now, since we are talking about the application of work energy theorem, and most of the time the pipe will be on the earth only. As a rare any pipe is on the moon or just somewhere, right? More than that will be a scenario. So what kind of potential energy we are dealing with? Gravitation potential energy. Right? So in order to derive the Bernoulli's theorem, I should not take a horizontal pipe. If I take a horizontal pipe, there is no potential energy difference. Okay? So that term will not come in the equation itself. So rather than taking horizontal, I will be taking inclined one. So that the potential energy term also come in the equation. Now there is a difference in potential energies if pipe is taken like that. Alright? Draw this pipe. Ron, stop talking. They're in a straight line. This is height h1. This is height h2. Guys, a word of caution, if you don't pay attention in this derivation, you will never understand it. I have seen it. For past 10 years, I have seen it. If you don't pay attention the first time, you are not going to understand this Bernoulli's theorem. Okay, then you have to rely on your memory to memorize everything and just like a vomit out and forget about it. Okay, I don't want you to do that. Okay, understand how things work so that you don't need to remember or memorize things. This is area cross section A1. This is A2. Okay, any doubt? Now, this is a cross section of a bigger pipe, so I will be drawing a dotted line like this. So, had it been open to the atmosphere, then pressure here would have been same as their atmospheric pressure, but it is not open to the atmosphere. Okay, so pressure over here is P1 and over there the pressure is P2. Okay, it is incompressible fluid, so density remains constant, rho. Okay, and the velocity with which it is coming from this side is V1, and velocity with which it is going out from there is V2. I need to draw velocity, pressure and everything else because I am going to apply work energy theorem over here and all of these terms will be used there. Any doubts till now? No? Okay, what does work energy theorem says? Keep quiet and tell me. Work done by other forces will be equal to what? U2 plus K2 minus U1 plus K1 It is same thing as saying U2 minus U1 plus K2 minus K1, yes or no? Same thing? Yes or no? Okay, now tell me between which two points I am applying the... Achha, before that you tell me on what I am applying work energy theorem. I'm not applying on the entire pipe, right? I'm not applying an infinite mass. On which object I'm applying work energy theorem here? Tell me. On the water that is inside this pipe, which is shown. From this point to that point, the entire water, for that I'm applying work energy theorem. Is it clear? Okay? So first you need to identify on which you are applying work energy theorem. Otherwise, how will you proceed, right? So I am applying work energy theorem for entire water starting from here to there. Okay, now you need to have point number 1 and point number 2. Between which two points you are applying work energy theorem, right? So what is that? This point and that point. They are not the two points in time. What I am trying to say is that if you are applying work energy theorem on a sphere and I ask you between which two points you are applying work energy theorem, you are not going to say I am applying work energy theorem from this point to that point of the sphere. Does it make sense? No. If the sphere comes from top and rolls down, then you can say okay, from this initial position of the sphere to the final position of sphere, I am applying work energy theorem. Yes or no? Okay, don't get confused by 1 or 2 written here. Rather than 1 or 2, let's change the notation. I'll write I and F. That would be better. This is UF minus UI, KF minus KI. Now tell me, where are those two points? Final and initial, where are they? Okay, those two, the time is this. This is the scenario right now. Just like in continuity theorem, we have taken scenario at t equal to 0 and scenario at dt time. Same thing we are going to do here. In dt time, whatever happens, or in delta t time, whatever happens, okay, to this entire fluid, that and at t equal to 0, whatever is happening, I am going to connect these two points with work energy theorem. Are you getting it? This entire fluid, listen here again. This entire fluid will move forward like this. Entire fluid will go forward like that. Okay? So I am going to apply work energy theorem at this situation and at that scenario situation. Fine? Right now what is the energy and now what is the energy? Between these two points, the entire fluid moving forward and right now what it is, I am going to connect these two things by using work energy theorem. Is it clear now? Okay? Now, is there any force that is doing work on this entire fluid? Is there any force, external force on the entire fluid? Gravity is there, understood. But for gravity, you are considering the potential energy. Right? So I will not find out the work done by gravity. Is there any other force other than gravity that is doing work? It is there. Tell me what it is. The force due to the pressure. This pressure is coming from outside, na? This pressure. P1 is outside this pressure, P2 is outside. Are you getting it? So P1 and P2 can create the external force on this entire fluid. Getting it? Okay. Now suppose in dt time, it moves forward by this much distance, which is how much? V1 dt. And suppose this move forward by V2 dt. Please draw this. Now tell me, work done by the pressure force P1. How much it is equal to? Work done by the force due to P1 pressure is what? Force is how much? Pressure into area. So P1 A1 is the force and displacement is how much? V1 dt. So force into displacement is work done? Yes or no? So force is P1 A1 into the displacement, which is V1 dt. This is the work done by P1 force. Any doubt? And work done by P2 force is how much?
P2 A2 V2 dt.
Now tell me what is wrong with this, the work done by P2 force. Something is wrong.
So it's outside.
The outside to yahan pe, yeah? Both sides it is outside. Something is wrong. See, you can say anything. Anyways, all of you are wrong. So whatever you say, most what will happen, you will be again wrong. Right? So there is something wrong with WP2. Whatever comes in your mind, please comment. Negative. The work done should be negative. Because pressure tries to push it this way. Yes or no? So force due to P2 force will push it that way. But displacement is happening in opposite direction. So work done will be negative. Right? Force and displacement are in opposite direction. So total work done, as in work done by the other forces, will be how much? P1 A1 V1 dt minus P2 A2. Any doubt? No doubts? Right? So this is the left hand side of the work energy theorem. Okay? Now let us try to find out. Can I proceed? Let us try to find out the change in potential energy. Final potential energy minus initial potential energy. Okay? What is the final position of the fluid? Final position of fluid is this. A, B, C, D. Are you getting it? So I can divide this entire thing in zones. I can say that this is zone 1, this thing is zone 2, and that thing is zone 3. You'll understand why I'm doing it. It becomes very simple like that. Now tell me, is zone 2 common between initial and final? Zone 2 is common, right? And was zone 3 present initially? No. Was zone 1 present finally? No. Getting it? So let us try to find out UF minus UI. It will be equal to potential energy of zone 1 plus potential energy of zone 2 plus potential energy of zone 3 finally minus, I have divided the entire mass into zones. Potential energy of zone 1 plus potential energy of zone 2 plus potential energy of zone 3 finally. Sorry, initially. Okay, here is the thing. This final potential energy of zone 2 and initial potential of zone 2, both are same. Zone 2's initial and final potential energy are same. Yes or no? Right? So I can just cancel out this. Zone 2 is common between initial and final. Okay? Initially zone 3 doesn't exist. So this is also gone. And finally zone 1 doesn't exist. That is also gone. Right?
Finally zone 1 doesn't exist.
So finally? Zone 1 doesn't exist. Oh, I have taken this as a. Sorry about that. So finally zone 1 doesn't exist, so this is final. And initially zone 3 doesn't exist, so that is initial actually, correct. So this is equal to potential energy of zone 3 minus potential energy of zone 1. Now tell me, how much is the potential energy of zone 3? What is the mass of zone 3? Density into volume, which is how much? A2 into V2 dt. This is mass. MgH is the potential energy. So that into G into what? H2. This is the potential energy of zone 3. Any doubt? Minus potential energy of zone 1, which is how much? Similarly, I can write it as A1 V1 dt into G into DH1. Getting it? Any doubt till now? Please ask. See, I am applying work energy theorem on this mass. this mass move forward, there is nothing here now. That is replaced by some other mass, but that is not my system. My system is only this mass which has moved ahead. I am applying Bernoulli's theorem on the mass which was initially present in this much pipe. Is this thing clear? Okay. This one. This is work which is theorem. Work done is U2 plus K2 minus U1 plus K1. Okay. Or zoom in. Here. Yes. This is U2 minus U1. Okay? Alright, now all of you, please find out. All of you, please find out similarly what is KF minus KI. Please find out yourself. You can again divide into zones. See, similarly, it will come out like this: kinetic energy of zone 3 minus kinetic energy of zone 1. Okay? It will come out to be like this. Now substitute the values. Anyone done? Half mv square only. M is rho into A into K1. Okay. So this will be equal to half. M is what? Rho into A1 V1 delta T. This M into V square. Any doubt? Oh, sorry. This is A2. Yeah. Correct. Minus of half rho A1 V1, this is dt, I am taking delta, V1 dt into V1 square. Got it? Understood? Now I can write continuity equation also here, yes or no? I can say that A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I can say that. Now I want you to substitute all of these values in this equation and simplify the terms. All of these, many things will cancel away. A2 V2, A1 V1, and DT 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 everywhere will get cancelled. So try to simplify it and come out with a simple expression. You can cancel out A1 V1 and A2 V2, both are same. And DT 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 will get cancelled out. Should I write down now? Okay, so you are going to get this. If you simplify everything, P1 plus half rho V1 square plus rho GH1 is equal to P2 plus half rho V2 square plus rho GH2. If you simplify everything, this is what you will get. Okay, now tell me, please write down this directly. We can't keep on waiting, right? And practice at home. Now tell me, where have we used the assumption that it is a laminar flow, not turbulent?
In the pipe.
Yeah. No, density can be considered in turbulent flow also. It is a property of fluid, not the type of flow. We have assumed that only the potential energy and kinetic energy exist. But when turbulent flow happens, there will be sound also will be involved. Okay? And it can create vibration and just several other losses are there. Frictional losses might be there. Okay? So turbulent flow will not have just these energies. There will be energy losses that will happen. So since you have ignored that energy loss it automatically means that you are considering only laminar flow. Okay, so please write down in brackets that the Bernoulli's theorem is only valid for the laminar flow. Okay, and invariably in any question which you are going to solve, you will assume that it is laminar flow until and unless stated otherwise. Nobody will write that, okay, assume it is laminar flow. You have to assume it is laminar until and unless stated otherwise. Okay? And few pointers here, guys, pay attention. Few pointers here. When you write P2 is equal to P1 plus rho g h, that h was depth. H was measured from the top. It was depth. Depth is measured from the top. This h is height. It is measured from the ground. Okay? That ground is your choice. You can draw that horizontal line before you start solving a question. You draw a line, you say that is my reference line, that you do in work for energy chapter also. Same thing here also. You can draw a line anywhere and say that this is my reference line, and then you can apply this Bernoulli's theorem. And one more thing, the Bernoulli's theorem is applied between the two points of the pipe, and these two points can be anywhere in the pipe. Fine? These are two points, and then if you look at this Bernoulli's theorem, since I can apply it at any two points, I can say that P plus rho V square plus rho G H is constant throughout the pipe. Can I say that? I can apply it between any two points as if it is remaining constant. As if it is the sum of all the energies in a flowing water. It represents conservation of energy or not? It represents. So it is as if some of these three types of energies are constant. Okay? Now, this is termed as, please write down pressure energy. Kya hua, Mr. Om? What happened? Shiv. I remember those kind of names. Very good at normal names. Okay, pressure energy. This is pressure energy per unit volume. This is kinetic energy per unit volume. And this is potential energy. Do not talk. This is potential energy per unit volume. So just like when we deal with fluid, we don't deal with mass. We deal with mass per unit volume. That is the density of the mass. Similarly, we don't deal with kinetic energy directly. We are dealing with density of the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy per unit volume. Similarly, you don't deal with potential energy directly. You are dealing with density of the potential energy. Because the water is continuously flowing. So you need to find the density of the energy. Are you getting it? Alright? So at times in a higher order numericals, it will be written that potential energy per unit volume is this much. It means that rho gh at that point is that. Fine? So this one new kind of energy is introduced here. This is called pressure energy. Don't get confused with it. It just represents that pressure does some work. Okay? So you are terming it as an energy. Alright? Any doubt in the derivation of Bernoulli's theorem? Anything? No doubt? Okay.